You're recording? Oh, all right. Okay, let's. All right, it's a recording. It's just a coffee. I usually don't drink coffee. So I did it now. And when I did that, this was recording on. Okay, anyways, I'm here to talk about the Fjällräven handlebar rack. Did I say that correct? Handlebar rack. Yeah, for the 20th time I said that correct. Handlebar rack. And we're also going to talk about this handlebar bag here from Fjällräven. And yeah, let's do it. Let's jump into it. So here we are. But first, before I'm gonna talk about this bar rack and this bar bag and bars and drinks and stuff, I'm gonna say this. I'm not sponsored at all. I bought this stuff myself, and actually I bought it on sale, so it's kind of a cheaper option than before. They are kind of expensive. And yeah, we're gonna talk about if it is worth the price, or is it good to go, or is it just crap? I don't know, because I haven't unpacked it yet. But I'm gonna tell a story about this. The purpose of why I'm buying this equipment was that I was out biking and I had the camera in my backpack as I usually have, and this A7 is a kind of a bulky little piece with the lens on it and everything. It's hard to get it out of the bag. So you need to stop, take off the bag, take out the camera, take the picture, then back in the bag again and back on the back and then bike. It's a little circus. So I want to have it easy when I'm out biking, because when you're out biking, sometimes you see stuff that you need to snatch your camera kind of fast and snap the photo. So I needed something that could fit my needs. It was really hard to find. It actually is. No one builds, you know, bags for cameras that fits on bikes. Everyone is talking about the right backpack for your camera. Well, that's a good option, but if you like to have your camera fast, it's not the best way to have it. And if you're biking gravel, you can have it on your bar, but if you go for mountain biking, no way that camera will end up in Japan if you jump. But anyways, this is for gravel biking and also for, like, you know, just biking around and having fun. Then you can use these handlebar bags for that purpose. So I was out looking for that and I slipped on Fjällräven bar bag. That's what it's called, it's bar bag. And it doesn't come with beer, it just comes with empty space, and it's super expensive for what you get. Actually, it is expensive. It's this bag here. And Fjällräven did this cooperation with Specialized, so they attached a Specialized logo in here, which makes lots of bikers go, I'm riding a Cannondale. I can't use Specialized stuff for my bike. Yeah, I hear you. But that's not my thing to do. I'm not religious to a brand. And I don't get paid for using a brand. I have them all. I have Cannondale, I have Trek, I have Specialized. I have them. It's just about the right equipment for the right purpose and the right time. That's what it's about. If it says, like, I don't know, something else here, like Big Burgers or something on this one, I don't care. Is it good to use? I will use it. So in this case, it's Fjällräven cooperated with Specialized, which maybe is their biggest mistake due to bikers' minds of religion, that if I'm biking a brand, I'm gonna stick to the brand. But I'm not like that, so I'm their friend, yeah, kind of. Anyways, so I find this bag, which is nice. It's have lots of space into it, you can see here, which fits my camera needs perfectly. So I bought this bag. First, I was just looking at it for the regular price. It was really expensive, so I was like, I'm gonna pay so much for a little bag they're gonna have on my bar like 10 times a year. It's not worth it. I will not do that. So I was just waiting and waiting and waiting and talked to the shop owner, like, can I get a discount? No. And it was like a big no. Then I find on the net that they put down the price 20%, and I just put up an order directly and bought it. With the 20% off, the price range was decent. It was not cheap, but it was decent. It was perfect. So I got this bag. Unfortunately, it's not coming with a rain cover, which is usually what bags used to do in this price range. So you need to buy that separately, which is not cheap either. But I bought this also on sale, so I got it cheaper, but it's still too expensive for a little bit of plastic to wrap this around to not get any water into it, because that should be included. The cover should be included in a bag. Evoque does that. Why can't you do that, Fjällräven? Why are you so special? Anyways, when I got this bag, I realized this bag is made for a rack specifically, a dedicated rack. And of course, they got a dedicated rack too, and it's here, the bar rack. It's also ridiculous expensive for a little piece of metal and some strings, which is in here, which you're gonna set on your bar. It's so ridiculous. But I found this also on sale because I'm a lucky guy. Sometimes I am lucky. I found this on a sale. I bought it. It was 40% off. I directly bought it and I got it. And I'm gonna mount it on my bike. And I don't have no clue if it's good or it's bad right now. So I'm gonna put it on my bike and see if it fits good. And then I'm gonna go out bike with the camera and all that jazz. So yeah, let's jump into it. Let's go outside and yeah, bike with this stuff. The bike is here. You see it's here. We're gonna put this here. Somewhere here maybe can be a good place. Bars. So yeah, let's do it. No, actually I'm gonna open this one up and show you guys what's inside here. It's a kind of a important thing, just show you. What we got inside here. It's not that there's plenty of things here, it's you know, cardboard. There you go. And it's a holder. That's what it is. So yeah, it will take a couple of minutes to put this on, but let's do it. And then we go outside and we try and ride and bring the camera with us and see what's up, okay? So yeah, we got to the finish line here. It's the lake here, Sweden's first biggest lake actually. It's a nice place to be, especially this day. It's like the first day of the spring kind of, so it's birds all over the place. No boats yet, some are, but well, it's not filled with boats like it used to be. So it's very quiet here, some people around I think. So yeah, let's talk about this bag. So I'll be biking for 20 kilometers on gravel. Just to test ride it and see what's up. It's really uneven. It's very bumpy roads and lots of hole into it, especially now after winter. And yeah, it takes impact. It does. And there are limitations to this bag. And I'm going to talk about that back in the studio. And you also need to do tons of modifications to make it perfect. So I'm going to talk about that. But well, let's drink this super strong cowboy coffee and bike back home. See you back in the studio. All right, so I'm back inside again. As you can see, the bike is behind me. It's here. I have the rack here. And I also have like a rear rack here from Thule, which is an awesome rack. And it's a little bit cheaper actually than the Fjällräven, which is a complete different story. So if you're looking for a front rack for your bike, the Thule is a really good option. It's really affordable, it's a nice price, and yeah, it takes much more load actually than the bar rack. That's not the reason why I bought this bar rack at first time. It was to support this bag. This bag is a great camera bag. I fill it up with some foam into it, and I could have my FX3 in here, and I can have like my drone in there and everything. Works really good for that. And also you attach it under with these straps under the rack, so it's really, I mean, it's solid, it fits there, and it will be steady as much as can be like. So that's really positive. This bag is really good with this rack support. But overall, this is my review. First of all, it's too expensive. This kit cost like 220 euros complete. It's really expensive for what you get. You get like a bar rack, yeah, you get the bar rack, but it's, I mean, it's not steady enough. It doesn't matter how hard you screw the screws to the bar, it will wiggle down. It will go down, it will. Especially when it's bumpy roads like the gravel roads, it will go down. So it's not reliable at all when it comes to stay in place. It doesn't. It's also attached with a string or a cord, if you like to, that will support this to not get out of place. But it doesn't work that way. It's really useless. Why did you bought that cord in the first place? First of all, it's really hard to strap it up and tighten it up. That's the first thing. And when you succeed with that, it's useless. If Fjällräven, don't do this mistake again, modify it, it's much better. What you can do if you buy this rack, and if you like to have this awesome photo bag to your bar, which, I mean, the kit is good, it's a good idea on the script table. It works kind of good out in the reality, but it could be better. So what you can do when you modify this one is to attach some old tube under the clamps. So if you do that, it will not slip down. Some bars are really slippy, so it will go down. That's why I bought this one, because I thought I can't build one myself. It's too complicated to get it in place. But, well, Fjällräven also had trouble with that. Fjällräven, you can call me if you'd like to have more suggestions of how to build a great bar rack. No worries, I will help you out. But if you are not that picky, and you're looking into a great photo bag, and actually a great travel friend overall, this bag is good, it is good. And if you can fix the bar that it stays in place, this will be like a good couple to have, but still it's really expensive. There are other options out there which could be better. But to be honest, I haven't found any better bag than this one for photo. First of all, it's a kind of hard shell-ish kind of bag. And you can put in foam in here and you get like a regular camera bag that you can have on your bar, because it's very reachable to have your camera gear on the bar. And also, this one is also a good thing. You have it closed when you're not on the bike. When you're taking the bag with you, you have straps, you can have it around the shoulder, and then you close it like a regular bag. When you're biking, you open that up and there is a hook on the bar, which you put this one on. And this little flip thing here, you just drag it and you open the bag. This is great. It's so great. That's a good job, Fjällräven. That's what you did with the design company. They did a great job with the bag just. But when it comes to the bar, you need to go back to the writing table and do it better. If you do, and you keep the same price, this will be a really great kit for photographers or riders who like to have something in a hard bag, very reachable. It will be good, but right now, the better option to have with you is the Thule front rack. It's actually the same as the rear rack here, you just put it in the front, it's the same solution. So if you're looking for a reliable rack, go for Thule. If you're looking for a photo bag kind of, and you find it on discount, buy Fjällräven, it's really good. But for the regular price, no, it's too expensive. I can't say that you're gonna buy it for that amount of money. You get like a legit photo bag for that money, which you can have in front of you on the Thule instead. So yeah, I don't know. It's not that I regret I bought this one, because I got it like a really good price. And I'm not paid to rave either, I'm just honest here. So for the price I got it for, it was like half the price. It's really decent and that's worth it. That's actually worth the price, but not for the regular price. I'm saying that again, it's not worth the money. Don't buy it. If you don't like to, you know, fix and tricks and modify and put some glue here and there, and then you get it on your handlebars and it will work great. Okay. I know what you're thinking, like, well, this is really heavy stuff that you carry with you with the housing and all that. Yes, it is. It is kind of heavy. So if you're bringing lighter products with you, like a jacket or something that you want to bring in here, and maybe a whiskey, it works fine for that. And maybe it stays better in place. But for my purpose of use, which is a camera bag, it must be more steady. It must sit in place, because when it goes down, I see my camera going down to the ground as well. It's a nightmare. So guys, yeah. Look over your needs, consider what I'm saying. Touch it, go down to the store and feel it. Feel the rack as well, it's super expensive. It's 120 euros for little aluminum. It's, yeah. They could do it better, actually, they could. So yeah guys, with that said, jump into my Instagram, subscribe and like this channel if you like to see more reviews, which is not pay to rave and it's just me and telling stuff about it. You just subscribe. Yeah, I'll see you next time and all that jazz. Peace, arrivederci, I'm out.